Russell Crowe, welcome back to the project. This movie is all about staying in the game, and that's certainly something that you've done over your career. Is that something you think about a bit?
Well, I think, Pete, as you get older, you can't actually help but have, you know, thoughts of legacy and all of those sort of things. It's just, you know, it's a natural part as your kids get older. You know, as your kids get legal age for pubs and start going to university and things like that, it's like you very definitely become aware that you're in a cycle, and maybe it's, you know, well beyond halftime. But, you know, it's funny because I'm even getting to the point where the idea of sitting and watching one of my movies is actually becoming attractive. So something's changed.
This is the second time you've worked with Russell Crowe, the director. What's he like to work with?
Oh, pain in the ass, man. You know, that guy.
Russell wasn't always signed on to direct Poker Face, and the timing certainly wasn't perfect.
Probably about 10 days prior to the phone call, my father passed away. So I'm dealing with that. And the phone call comes, you know, and the tag of all this is that we're in a pandemic. City of Sydney's about to go into a lockdown. There's 280 crew people who basically will just lose their job, lose their means of employment and keeping food on the table for their families if somebody doesn't say yes. And it was a completely imperfect situation for any kind of creative activity, let alone something as full and as full of responsibility as a feature film. But, you know, I'm my father's son, Peter, and it was important that everybody kept their job.
My condolences for the loss of your dad. Was he on your mind a lot during the production?
Absolutely. He really was. And the last line of the film is actually a line that he used on my niece when she was going through a particularly difficult time in her life. And he said to her, you know, you can't be hanging around with people who want to judge life by whether it's, you know, the glass is half empty or whether it's half full. You have to understand that you always have the capability of refilling the glass, you know. So he was definitely on my mind, you know, the entire time. And some of that was negative because it was a huge responsibility. And I'd be going, mate, what have you made me do here, you know?
From a poker king to a Greek god, Russell's having a hell of a year and seems to be collecting Hemsworths along the way.
Liam is great in Poker Face, and of course you worked with Chris in Thor, Love and Thunder. We had him on the show. He said you got a little bit embarrassed because he was naked standing in front of you wearing only a modesty sheath.
Did he call it a sheet, did he?
No, he called it a sheet.
I would have called it a flannel. I wouldn't have called it a sheet. Listen, man, you just got to give it up to that kid, don't you? Holy shit, man.
Let's see who you are. I take off your disguise. And flick.
Flick too hard, damn it!
Yeah, I had such fun on that set with Taika Waititi and with Chris, because Chris is up for anything. And then you got Taika, who's, you know, I mean, just some kind of mad genius, man, you know? And he's got a huge soul. And, you know, I mean, I was throwing stuff in left, right and center. I was trying to get in multiple references to olive oil. I was, you know, and it was all very, very inappropriate. And at one point in time, one of the executives, I think he said to Taika, after seeing what we'd shot one day, he said, Walt Disney is spinning in his grave if this isn't a Disney film.
You need your lightning bolt.
My lightning bolt is called Thunderbolt. So I think to use somebody's secret weapon like this, that you should at least get the name right when you ask.
What is your favorite movie-making memory?
I think the secret, Pete, me old mate, is I love my job, right? So it makes it very easy for me. It's 4 o'clock in the morning. Other people are hating their life, but I'm getting up because I've got X dialogue I'm delivering today, and I can't wait because I have a plan, you know? It's funny because somebody was chipping at me the other day for the Greek accent as Zeus, you know? And they actually use the phrase, stay in your lane. What's my lane, Peter? What's my lane, you know? Is it a neo-Nazi skinhead in Romper Stomper? Is it a detective from the 1950s in LA Confidential? Is it a mathematician? Is it a tobacco scientist? Is it a Roman gladiator? What's my lane, mate? The bottom line is, I love my job. So even at the age of 58, I'm not burnt, I'm not cynical. You know, I'm looking forward to the next one. You know, you can let lots of things in life sort of burn you down. But, you know, if you approach everything from that core perspective, you know, these are the people I love. These are the things that I love doing. You know, this is the energy I want to give to somebody else. You know, I think, you know, that's the way to keep bouncing along.
He's the best.
He can faint at the Hemsworths.
Hang on.
He's just amazing.
Yeah, he's awesome.
Yeah, and you sort of forget so how much funny. Incredible work he's done until you see it sort of packaged like
but
that.
But also I think, you know, sometimes it seems to be in the life of an actor where, particularly when they find fame, great fame, that they get very closed about themselves. But yeah. He's just opening up more and more about himself. Yeah. Like that stay in your lane business, it's like, he's talking to the heart of people being accused of cultural appropriation or whatever. He's like, I'm an actor. That's what I do. Yeah. I just love him. He's so eloquent and he's handsome. I love him.
Yeah. But also being reminded of all of his roles.
Yes.
You forget half of them. There's
Hello,
so many
Romper
amazing
Stomper.
Ones.
Got a lot of lines. you can see Russell's poker face when it premieres on the 22nd of November on Stan.